Welcome back to vlog number 23. I want to start off by saying happy holidays, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I wish you nothing but health and success and all the good stuff that comes with it. I want to start off by saying it's been an incredible year. A lot of reflection going on, a lot of things that we've been pondering on, and what's kind of the mission going into 2019. It has been an interesting year since we launched in March. We have done a lot of good things, but we have also done a lot of bad things. What we've done good, we've managed to start outsourcing and trusting others. We've linked up with a marketing team who has helped us, done a tremendous job in our social platforms, from the engagement to the consistency to the content, the quality of content that we have produced. It's phenomenal. I have nothing but good words to say about them, and I thank them for their support in this endeavor. I think going forward, we should continue to grow and start spreading into other platforms, not only Instagram and Facebook, which have been the primary focus, but also Twitter, and start building email lists and doing more for our viewers as far as the YouTube channel and growing those as well. I want to give a shout out to the models and our brand ambassadors who have been a tremendous asset to us, and it is just the beginning. We're looking to do a lot more with them and grow together. So let's talk now about where we left off. We were talking about our brand ambassador program, we were talking about our samples developing and kind of preparing for that Black Friday, Cyber Monday. From the brand ambassador perspective, it was phenomenal. We did interviews. We're going to showcase those and show you some of the work that we put in. From the samples perspective, we hit a rough period, I want to say. And this is something I want to kind of make everybody aware. There's going to be times when you outsource, you are looking to find manufacturers, maybe you don't have the connections, but you know somebody who does, and you're outsourcing that. Be very careful and take full responsibility. And when I mean take full responsibility, don't let that middleman or that person, don't expect them to do the work you would, the way you would do it. I have come across a situation where the person in charge of this job, it's not that they did a bad job, it's just that they weren't doing it like I would have done it. Whenever a problem comes up, I will take full responsibility and try to come with a solution. I don't come to the person that I'm giving my word to or doing business with another problem or telling them what the problem was. I'm trying to come up with a solution. And I think it's very imperative that a lot of us start doing that and work in that manner, because it so happens that I got delayed. I had, as previously mentioned, we're working with two manufacturers, samples from California and samples from China. The ones from China never made it here. We always waited and waited and waited, and look at this, it's December and I don't have a new product, and I'm now screwed because I don't have anything new for the people. And I'm not gonna talk about the emotional side of things, but I will say this. Something like this, a moment like this where you promise something or you build your audience and you tell them that you have a new product coming and you're getting delayed by a manufacturer, can be quite costly. From a time and investment perspective, you gotta be extremely careful. We had discussions about the future of the company because of You know, also Black Monday, Black Friday, Cyber Monday was not the most spectacular, solely because, you know, part of it comes from the product being very unique, and without a doubt it is a beautiful product, but it's very hard to sell because the niche, the market is so small, and it's very few people out there with the confidence to wear such a product. Not only that, especially when you're a new brand, a new company, nobody knows you, you don't have a name, you don't have a standard, nobody knows what to expect. It's hard to convince the customers to really go your way. So all that in a nutshell, one of the main reasons I want to talk about this now, it's the fact that the year is coming to a close and we're evaluating everything that we've been doing good, and we're trying to find a path going forward. I'm bringing this up because it's imperative that you take responsibility when you own a business and watch every single thing and make sure you hold yourself accountable over everything, over every single thing. Even though you have people doing other jobs, from the marketing to maybe perhaps design or manufacturing, you need to have an eye and ear everywhere, and everything needs to be followed up on and be consistent with. Otherwise, just like that, a month can be lost, and a month can mean a lot of money for you. Regardless, going forward, the positive, the good stuff, let's talk about it. I am preparing new designs as we speak. There are shirts and crop tops for men and women. I'm also working on a duffel bag. We're gonna give it 3 months. That's kind of our deadline, so to say, where we will push for sales. So far, I think one of the mistakes that we have done this year, we have focused so much on content and creating content and making sure that we have structure and that we figure out our niche market, that we forgot what we're in this for, which was sales, which would feed the business. Another idea in 2019 that I want to build upon is our community. And in 2018, we have done a great job of linking up with people. Especially lately, we were part of a tremendous pop-up where we have managed to build a lot of connections within the city of Detroit. And I want to be part of more of these type of events, especially in the community, especially around the Detroit area. I think Detroit is coming back tremendously. If you go in the downtown area, everything is being remodeled, and there's new buildings at every corner, new stores. Detroit is coming back, and I want to be part of that community and part of that growth. I think in 2019, I go in with a new view, a new understanding of what matters for myself and the future of the company, and I'm extremely excited about giving it my all. I will make another vlog where I will talk more about the new designs, and I will talk more about the developing and the developing process, and kind of how we're gonna market those products. That's coming up probably next week. I want to thank all of you. I want to thank everyone who supported us throughout this project. And I wish all of you nothing but happiness and success. And may 2019 be the year where you accomplish more than you've accomplished in the previous years. Keep in mind that you're just starting out. Keep in mind that is the beginning. Be kind to others, do more for others. This is one thing that I want to do myself. Do what you love and strive to find what that is if you don't know. And most of all, live life on your own terms. I'll see you guys in the next one. Hi guys, thank you very much for watching. As you can see, what we're trying to do is document our journey to the top and show you all the behind the scenes and how we're building our business and brand. For more, please leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one.